My name is Prabhu Salgiri, Vice President Vijayan and Travis, Division of VR and Logistics Limited.
Okay, so being recognized with the World Travel Brand Award status, how does it feel? And you can mention the award that you've also won.
Yeah, World Travel Brand Award, it is a prestigious award for Vijayan and Travels because since ever we started, this is the first recognition to Vijayan and Travels as far as awards is concerned. So we are happy for the honor, whatever World Travel Brand Award Academy has given up to us.
How have you made your brand better than your competition?
See, in the year, basically it is a logistics company. In the year 1976, our founder Mr. Vijay Sankeshwar started this company as a proprietorship firm from the remote place called Gadag in North Karnataka of Karnataka state. Initially started with one truck, but gradually he expanded the business. Now VR Logistics Limited is the biggest transporter recorded in the Limca Book of Record also for running more than 4000 trucks. So in the year 1996 the company started this division Vijayan and Travels to cater the needs of traveling passengers, because at that time the travel scenario was very bad, customer was exploited like anything, and there was no good luxury coaches for the remote places. Only in the metros and all some good buses were there, but we basically from a Northern Karnataka company, we concentrated more on the remote parts of the Karnataka to cater good luxury services. We started in the year 1996 with two luxury buses, initially plying between Hubli and Bangalore, and we got very good response. It was a category of 2+1 seater bus, mostly preferred by lady travelers who travels alone. Safety was the first priority. So that category popularity came like anything. Then after that we went on adding the buses to our fleet. So now we are running more than 500 buses, and we are present in 8 states. Mainly we are market leaders in South India, and our brand is totally different from other brands because of the punctuality, hygiene, cleanliness, and most of the lady travelers, they travel without any fear, because nowadays the safety of lady travelers is at stake at every part of the country. So one more pioneer thing what we have achieved in this industry, last year we launched Bangalore Ahmedabad service. It is a distance of 1600 kilometers. So many people laughed at us, 1600 kilometers who will travel by a road journey. So we made it a success because we knew some things by our logistics division's achievements. Around 10 lakh people are residing in, 10 lakh Gujarati people are residing in Bangalore. They don't have option to travel except air and train. Train almost 3 months they are full, and air is not affordable to all community, all category of passengers. So keeping this in mind, we started Bangalore Ahmedabad service. It was a great success, and that time it was India's longest bus route. After that, we also launched Bangalore Jodhpur service also, which is 2035 kilometers. We are covering in 36 hours, and occupancy level is more than 90%. So we are in its own way giving better service compared to competitors. So the brand image is very good.
What are your growth plans?
Every year we are adding buses, and we are expanding to many sectors, because still there are lot of routes which are potential and we are not covered at. So we are planning to add buses, and we are planning to give more service because of the online booking and all. There is because of the express quadrilateral, road conditions and all, they are very good now. So there is bright future for travel industry.
Okay, how do you keep your team inspired and motivated?
So our home team, we are giving very good facilities to our team, as best in the industry compared to competitors, and they are all dedicated. They work like a individual, as a proprietor, not as an employee.
Okay. What are the strengths of India as a travel destination for the world, and why?
Actually, there are lot of scope is there for tourism development. Unfortunately, there is no proper support or encouragement from the governments, as far as the tourism industry is concerned, there is sticky laws are there, and lot of heavy taxation revenue is paid by tourism segment. But even then, there is no scope of the government. If government encourages, there is a bright future for the tourism growth in the country.
Okay, which according to you are the must visit places in India and why?
There are many places in India because India is a very different country with different cultures. Every part of the country is having one special place. You may take Madurai, you may take Goa, you may take Tirupati. So many places are there to see in India. There is bright future for the tourism.
Do you want to again say what are the strengths of India in particular for as a travel destination?
See, one thing is this religious places as well as tourist places. There are a lot of religious places and also a lot of seashore tourism is not captured by any tourism government also. You can take the example of Karnataka itself. There is a Sahyadri forest, thick forest, and lot of tourism falls and all, they are there. But for the people coming from Mumbai or Delhi, it is amazing. But there are no facilities for the accommodation, there are roads and all, still there are lot of bottlenecks. If we overcome these bottlenecks, there is definitely government may also get good revenue out of tourism. There is a scope for it.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.